All right, this is grade 5, module 1, lesson 5. And in this lesson, we're going to be talking about the various forms of expanded notation for writing decimals, using fractions, using decimals, using word form, and all that sort of stuff. And so what that means is this place value chart is going to be crazy important during this lesson, teachers. So make one, maybe make a big one and put it on your wall so that students have ready access to it. You know, GLAD strategies say, hey, put it on the wall and allow the students to walk up to that wall and touch the chart as well so that they can really own this and really understand it. So let's get started. All right, so the first thing it says is express as decimal numerals. The first one's done for you. So the idea is we're going to be using this place value chart in order to take the words and turn it into a decimal. Let's take a look at 35 thousandths. So when it says 35 thousandths, that 35 means we're going to put, 35 thousandths. But you got to remember that you can only, for every 10 that you have in a column, you can cash it in for one in the next column to the left. So we have 30, so 30 thousandths, which each 10 thousandths can be cashed in for one of these. So really, the proper way of writing this, and let me write this in there, is really, instead of having 30 thousandths, it would be 3 hundredths and 5 thousandths. And then we'd have a zero right here. So the idea is 35 thousandths would look like this. 35, and then you know you're kind of correct because it ends in that thousandths column. All right, so 0.035. Now, you'll notice down here, I don't have a leading zero. But I put one here. It's customary. A lot of teachers require it, but it's actually not mandatory. So that just means there's no ones, and then no ones, no tenths, 3 hundredths, and 5 thousandths, or also known as 35 thousandths. Oh, let's do 800 and 5 thousandths. Let's do D. Okay, 800 and, okay, so that first part. 800 and, all right? Well, that means you have 8 in the 100. There's our 800 and. The word and oftentimes means, is interpreted as, there's the decimal. So 800 and. Now, this next part says 5 thousandths, which simply means we're going to put a 5 in the thousandths column, fill in these missing zeros. So our answer is 800 and 5 thousandths. So this is more of the same, only now they're giving us fractions and we're still supposed to write it as a decimal. So this first one, 8 thousandths. Well, that's really straightforward. That's 8 in the thousandths column and that's it. So what's in the hundredths column and the tenths column? Big old fat zeros. And there's our decimal. So the answer is 0.008. So there's our answer, 8 thousandths. Now remember, it's customary, although not required, that a leading zero in front of that decimal, we put that there. There you go. Now let's do H. Oh, H is a good one. 300 and 502 thousandths. All right, so the first part, that 300. So that's going to look like this. 300. There's our 300, and there's our decimal. Now that 502 thousandths. Now, 502 thousandths might look like this, but you're not allowed to have more than one digit per column. So what that means is you can cash these thousandths in for some hundredths, and then you can cash the hundredths in for some tenths, such that really, this 5 goes way over here, this 0 goes right here, and then the 2 is where it is, and there's our 502 thousandths, all right? So our proper decimal is 300 and 502 thousandths. Now you know you're right because you see the word thousand, or see the number thousand there. And our last digit ends in the thousandths column. So that kind of is a way to provide feedback that your student is correct. So teachers, are you seeing how important this table is? Man, just get these tables, put them on the wall, and let kids just constantly see them every day. So now here it says express each of the following values in words. So we oftentimes I allow my students to begin by putting this value in the chart. Okay, so 0.008. We have no tenths, no hundredths, so we have 8 thousandths. So we would write 8 thousandths. Oops, thousandths. There it is. With a THS at the end. All right. Oh, let's do this one. Oh my goodness. 607.409. So let's start by writing it down. So it's 607.409. Now this first part, that's pretty straightforward. That's 607. So I'm going to write 607. And. Now, why did I put the and? Because I've reached the decimal. Now, this next part right here, we've got 4 tenths, we have no hundredths, and we have 9 thousandths. So, but you're not going to say 4 tenths and 9 thousandths. What we're going to say is we're going to say 409 thousandths, because that's where we ended up in, 409 thousandths. So now I need to write and 409 thousandths. Thousandths. Good luck having your students trying to fill all that in on one line. All right, next page. So here it says write a number on the place value chart. Write the number. All right, so 3, 6, 2, right there. Then it says, then write it in expanded form using fractions or decimals to express the decimal place value units. So the idea is we know that these are the fractions notation, but what would the decimal notation look like? Well, the decimal notation, tenths, looks like this. 0.1, and then hundredths looks like this, 0.001, and then thousand, oops, I'm sorry, that's not quite right. Let's see, let's take that and start all over. So the tenths is 0.1, hundredths is 0.01, and then the thousandths is 0.001. All right, so if we wanted to express this number, let's start as with decimals. So we've got right here 3 copies of the tenths. So we're going to write 3 times 0.1 plus we have 6 copies of the hundredths. So it's going to be 6 times 0.01 plus we have 2 copies of the thousandths. So it's going to be plus 2 times 0. So here we go. It says write a decimal for each of the following. Use that place value chart to help. And I'm absolutely going to write that place value chart. So here's what how I think of it. I look at this 3 times 10. And I think of that as 3 copies of the tens. This means 5 copies of the 1. This means 2 copies of the tenths. So I'm going to put a 2. This means 7 copies of the hundredths. So I'm going to put a 7. And this means 6 copies of the thousandths. So I'm going to put a 6. And right here is our big old decimal. And so there's our decimal notation. It's going to look like this. 35.276. The proper way of saying that is 35 and 276 thousandths. Now let's practice this on problem C. This one's a little tricky. So this says 5 copies of 1,000. Oops, my chart doesn't go that high. Now it does. So 5 copies of 1,000, so I'm going to put a 5 right there. 4 copies of 100, so that's going to go right here. 8 copies of 1, so I'm going to put the 8 right there. This says 6 copies of the hundredths, so I'm going to put a 6 right there. And this says 5 copies of the thousandths, so I'm going to put the 5 right there. Now we have some gaposis here. We have a little gap here and a gap here. What goes there? Well, we're going to put in zeros because we don't have any tens and we don't have any tenths. So we're going to put in zeros. And that means, of course, our decimal goes right here. So the decimal notation is 5408.065. Proper way of saying that would be 5,408 and 65 thousandths. All right, so on this one, we've got Mrs. Herman, and we're asked to take this decimal, and I'm going to write that in here, 412.638. And it says, Nancy wrote the expanded form using fractions, and then Charles, well, let's do it in blue, and Charles wrote it using decimals. So remember, you just think about copies. So let's do Nancy first, and we'll do it in blue. So Nancy wants to do it in fractions. So she's got, Nancy has 4 copies of 100, plus she has 1 copy of the 10, plus she has 2 copies of the 1, right here, plus she has, now we're doing it as a fraction here, 6 copies of the hundredths, I mean of the tenths, 6 copies of the tenths, plus, now I'm going to have to, I'm going to wrap this around, 3 copies of the hundredth, plus 8 copies of the thousandths. 1, 2, 3 zeros. There you go. So that's Nancy. Now, Charles, we're going to do his in red. He did it in decimals. So remember, when over here for the tenths, what does a decimal look like? That's 0.1. And what does the hundredths look like? It's 0.01. And what does the thousandths look like? It's 0.001. All right, so what does Charles look like? Well, 4 hundredths, so that's still going to be 4 times 100, plus 110, 1 times 10, plus 2 copies of the 1s, so 2 times 1. Oops, I put a dot. Plus... All right, 6. So that's going to be 6 copies of the tenths. So I'm going to put 6 times 0.1 plus, now for the 3, that's 3 copies of the hundredths. So 3 times 0.01 plus, and I have to scooch that into another line, 8 copies of the thousandths. So that's 8 times 0.001. And so there's our 2 examples. One written as fractions, and one written as decimals. And that wraps up a doozy. That's module, 5th grade module 1, lesson 5, writing decimals in expanded form using decimal notation and fraction notation.